for your goodness and your mercy towards us.
Yeah, sing, Brandon.
This here is done getting me down. I'm turning it over, turn over, run down. I'm done stressing, and I'm through.
Good family, and welcome to Elevate. Yo, we're excited. Yes, we are. Listen, season two has been bananas. We've had a lot of people on, a lot of different things might have happened in this season, but we're so happy to end it with on a powerful big bang. If this is your first time at Elevate, listen, we will not disappoint. Thank you so much for tuning in with us tonight on Elevate, because here we come to encourage, inspire, and yes, give you a relevant word to hold on to. I got my mans in the house. Yes, my mans, my friends. He is good, man. Hey, you gonna meet him? Let's meet him without further ado, can we? All right, his name is Brandon McCord. Make some noise.
I'm glad to be here.
We were just talking, right? I was telling him I haven't seen him since he was young, single, no kids. Like, I mean,
a whole lot has changed.
A whole lot.
For the better.
There you go. Let me throw that out there. For the better. Absolutely.
So this is
Brandon. A lot of y'all may not know Brandon. He's a good friend of mine. I met him a long time ago at a church service. And so Brandon, we have people who literally watch from all over the world. Can you tell them a little bit about yourself? Like who you are, where you from, what you do, who
Absolutely.
Your peoples are, you know, all that kind of good stuff.
Absolutely. Yeah. I'm Brandon McCord. I'm born and raised in Miami, Florida.
305.
Actually went to school not far from here, okay. Miami Carroll City Senior High School.
Get
That's
out,
my
Carroll
school.
City.
Yeah, we right around the corner. We're in my stumping ground. We are in my stumping ground.
Okay, one time.
Absolutely.
Okay, watch
but
out.
But yeah, I'm the executive pastor there at the Zion Church, Pompano.
Okay.
Under Pastor Nathan Alston. Mm-hmm. I serve as his executive pastor and also as the youth pastor there.
Good.
And when I'm not doing that, yeah. I'm actually a sergeant for a local law enforcement agency here
Good
in the Tri-County
answer.
Area.
Sometimes.
Sergeant,
nice.
So when I'm not doing ministry, I'm out patrolling the streets and doing my thing.
Nice.
But you know, I'm real glad to be here.
Yeah.
Got my wife is at home. Shout out to her,
Woo-hoo!
Dr. Jazz,
yeah.
And my one-year-old, little Miss Mila.
Changed
my whole, yeah, I got a one-year-old running around the house.
Oh my God, you're a mini-me.
Y'all pray. Pray for me.
God is good. Listen, God is good. You hear me? God is really good. He will answer your prayers and give you the desires of your heart.
Yes, he will.
Because Brandon was Brandon, okay? and God has blessed him with a wife, with a doctorate.
Wonderful.
He got a child that looks like a little girl. God is doing some amazing things.
Yes, he is.
That's really good, man, Brandon.
Yes,
that really is.
I'm blessed. I can't complain.
A lot has happened in a short period of time, huh?
Yes,
you feel
has.
Like it's all been worth the wait.
It's been worth it, you know.
Yeah.
It's been a season of transition.
Gotcha.
But you know, sometimes transition is hard, but it's good.
Yeah.
And you come out on the other side better because of it. So that's been my story. And but it's been elevation, really.
Yes, it has.
Actually at our church it's our year of elevation.
Okay.
That's our theme for the year. So
let's go.
It's been elevation.
Absolutely.
Man. And, you know, at every level comes some discomfort, but we've been pushing through it.
That's
we're pushing
it.
Through
that's
it.
Because you weren't even ordained when I met you, bro.
No.
Like look at God.
No, a little over a year ago.
Pastor,
yeah.
I'm trying to tell you. Listen,
Absolutely.
God is doing some phenomenal things in people's
Absolutely.
Lives. Listen,
Absolutely.
People are saying like the pandemic happened and things like that, but I can tell you prospered through it all, man. Like God is
I got no complaints.
Look at that.
I got, you know, and I know some people struggled and some things happened, but
that's not
the amount of elevation that happened and the shifting that happened through that pandemic was just amazing. I mean, it literally, things that probably would not have happened happened because of the circumstances in which we had to deal with. So I'm blessed, I'm grateful. Listen, all things work together, right?
All things work together for the good. Absolutely.
That has been my story.
Absolutely. He can even take the pandemic and COVID and make it for our good, right?
That's right.
I mean, he can when he wants to push us forward, pull up back when we need to be pulled back.
That's right.
God, he makes the difference and he makes it for our good.
Yes,
it's some
absolutely.
Good stuff. So listen, Brandon is in ministry, he's Family Guy now. but he's also in these streets, right? He's a police officer. Yeah. I mean, he's a nice little ranking one too, you know.
got some stripes. He got some stripes.
He's been out there. Also, he's from Carroll City. He's from right in the heart of Miami, so he knows about it. Like, how did you get into law enforcement?
You know, it's something I always wanted to do. I knew from a young age that I wanted to do it, and for me, it was about you know, making it out of a situation that a lot of people don't make it out of.
Gotcha.
Inner city, growing up in that, and I saw that, you know, it was either one way or the other way that
gotcha.
You could go.
Yeah, yeah.
And I decided to take the way that would, you know, keep me out of trouble. And you know, really it's about helping people. It's okay. A job of service. And it relates to ministry a lot, because you a lot of times you meet people at their lowest point.
Mm-hmm.
No one really calls the police because right. they're having a good day.
That part.
And you know, it's about what can I do, you know, to whatever crisis they're going through, how can I help?
Absolutely.
You know, how can I get them out of that crisis? And it's different every day. I love what I do. And it really is about helping people. And, you know, at this juncture of my career, being a supervisor,
right.
it's about kind of trying to mold these young guys
gotcha.
And girls that wear a badge and a gun to do it the right way.
To do it the right way. Yeah. Now, listen, we know that in our country, we have seen a plethora of misuse of force and power among our community, right? The
yeah.
black and brown people.
Yeah.
And we've seen that happen often. And I think people have lost some trust
That's right.
in the people who wear the badge because,
That's right.
you know, we get the depiction and we've seen it on several occasions where the people who are supposed to protect us
That's right.
are the same ones that's violating us or hurting us. What do you say to bring back comfort or confidence back to those individuals? Because we know everybody's not the same.
Right.
And you're in that position
right.
every day.
You know? I'm fortunate to work with some amazing people
okay.
that do this job. And one thing I know is that the ones who do it the wrong way are the few.
Gotcha.
It really are. I mean, there are okay. thousands and thousands of cops that are out there doing it the right way.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, it's about a small difference. If all of us can make a small difference, then we can make a big difference together.
Yeah, yeah.
And for me, it's about making sure that whoever I come into contact with in the community, that they have a positive experience.
Gotcha.
That maybe I can change their perspective
yeah.
on what they think about law enforcement. And the people that work for me,
mm-hmm.
you know, I try to instill in them that, hey, when you come into contact with somebody, when you are talking to somebody, make sure that whatever they thought about law enforcement before that interaction,
mm-hmm.
that you change it for the better.
That's really good.
And really, it's just about treating people right.
Yeah.
You know, your
yeah.
badge and your gun and your uniform
yeah.
doesn't make you better than anybody.
Gotcha.
Treat people right. Treat people with respect.
Yeah.
And one thing I know, and I've been doing the job a long time, is that the people in the community
mm-hmm.
are your best asset.
That's true.
You know, and you never know how helpful they can be. And so I'm
That's
grateful.
Good.
I'm grateful that I'm in that position
yeah.
to kind of try to bridge the gap.
Absolutely.
Between those who may have lost trust in law
yeah.
enforcement and just trying to repair those relationships in whatever small way I can.
Yeah, definitely. Because, I mean, we keep hearing these hashtags and we keep hearing these stories, but it's good to know that we do have people, God-fearing people,
That's right.
who have badges as well, who are lifting up the light and the standing and really going out there because they want
right.
to serve people. They
That's
got it
right.
the right way. Is there a depletion, if you will? Is there a lack of, black and brown people into the
You know, I think the numbers department? Could be a little bit higher.
Okay, a little bit higher.
It definitely could be higher.
Okay.
So
what would you say to promote someone to say, like, listen, you know, come be with us. If it's something that you want to do, like, how would you say to a young guy or a young girl who may
yeah.
not know what they want to do with their future,
right.
but they like serving, right? They like, you know, helping people.
Right.
And this may be an avenue for them.
Right. You know, and I've been fortunate to help people get into law enforcement. Some people
yeah,
I went
yeah.
to school
you
with.
You didn't even offer me that. Like, man.
I didn't know you were interested.
He didn't
know you were interested.
Listen,
I didn't know you were interested.
People need jobs out here. He didn't even say he had a job.
You know,
now he say something. See what I'm saying? That's how people do.
I can't guarantee you a job,
yes,
but I can lead you down the right way.
Okay,
I can
I'll
help
take
you out.
The rest of the way. You throw the pitch, I'm going to hit it. You know what I mean?
And you know, for me, it's about reaching back and trying to pull some people into it. I've been fortunate. People that I know, I've been able to help guide them into law enforcement. And, you know, one thing that I want people to know is that it's a very rewarding career.
Yeah.
You know, it's a very rewarding career. No day is going to be the same.
Gotcha.
And it's an honorable job to do. And listen, you'll get paid well. You're not going to become a millionaire doing it,
okay.
you know, but you get paid well. You get benefits, all those things that people want in a job.
Good.
You're going to be tight. You're
okay.
going to be good.
Okay, good. So when
you
lay down at
retirement.
Night, you'll be good.
Yeah, you good.
Okay, you'll be mad like, man, why I got
No, you're going to be good.
Brandon got me up here, and these people, they You ain't trying to pay me nothing. Okay,
you'll be happy.
Okay,
you'll be set if you do it the right way.
Good.
You get a good retirement. You can live a good life. But really, it's about the reward that comes from serving. And really, especially those of us who grew up in communities that need good policing.
Yeah.
Because
talk about
because
it.
Because you have an understanding from a different perspective of what is needed from law enforcement in your community.
Absolutely.
So why not go back? We always talk about going back and reaching back and giving back to our community. Mm-hmm. For me, one of the best ways you can give back to your community is putting on a badge and a gun and going serving that community.
Nice. Absolutely, absolutely. Giving back or paying it forward, however you want to do it, definitely do it for your community and because they need it, definitely. We know
That's the
people who need it the most are definitely our people in our community. I love it. And this is a message for somebody too, though, because people think you can only do ministry behind the pulpit, right? You can only do ministry preaching or teaching or whatever. No, God is not limited to a building or a pulpit. Come
That's
on.
Right. That's
he
right.
wants us to go throughout the earth, right? And minister the gospel to those who will hear, right? Yeah. There's a world out there that needs us and our influence.
That's right.
And so he has people like Brandon, like, listen, he put the badge on. He still loves God. He's a preacher, as you can tell, but also he's going within the community and continuing to serve. And that's what God wants. Don't limit God because you have limit thinking. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
God
has
said today, listen,
that's
I'm bigger than just the pulpit. Yes, I've called you to ministry. Find out what kind of ministry I called you to. He's an act of service. Come on, somebody. That's a gift that he's operating in each and every day. He's not preaching each and every day. Yes, he goes and ministers. Yes, he does. Minister to his community. Minister to the people he see and come in contact with. And that's what God wants us to do. Continue to be the beacon and the light. That's what's up, Brandon. Look at you. Dude, I know your mama proud.
She's proud.
I know
she's
proud. Is proud.
Shout out to my mama.
Yeah, what time for the moms? All right, listen, here at Elevate, you all know what it is. We play Word Association. That's right, Word Association. I'm going to get Brandon a word. Hey, from that word, he's going to have to sing a song. That's right. I'm expecting Brandon to hit a little tune, play a little note, you know what I'm saying? See how it's going to go down. He's not going to get all day to do it because, why? We don't have all day to be here. People got things to do, people to see. Come on. So we're going to give him 12 seconds on the clock, and I'm going to give him a word. You ready, Brandon?
I'm ready.
Let's
I'm
go.
Ready.
Hey,
oh,
you see his T-shirt. I'm
go.
Going with him. Let's go. It was God. All right, here we go. Let's go with our first word today, shall we? Let's go with one. I think I want to go with this one. Let's go with presence.
Presence.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I'm going to go with a Bishop Clint Brown song.
Okay.
He says, your presence amazing, your glory surrounds me, your love completing me. That's it.
Presence. All right. I thought he was going to go, the presence of the Lord is here.
Nah, I'm going to go a little unorthodox. Some people don't know.
They don't know, but I love it, Brandon. I love it. Yes, your presence. Awesome, Brandon. Yeah, we need the presence of God, though, definitely, man.
All day, every day.
Especially you, huh?
Yes.
So what, do you have like a routine when you wake up in the morning before you go out? Because I know y'all work them long shifts and stuff.
Yeah, work a long 12-hour shift.
Yeah.
You know, I'm working overnight, so I'm all out of whack.
See, I'm already hot.
I'm going in later. You know, I gotta go in tonight.
Okay.
But I kind of wake up midday,
okay.
Get myself together, have some prayer and some devotional time, some time to myself just to get my thoughts together, have some coffee, and a little breakfast. I usually have breakfast when people are having lunch.
Okay. Right.
But,
all off.
If I need to do anything around the house, and then I just get myself ready to go.
Nice. That coffee is something. Listen to me. That coffee will bless you when you got to do them long hours work for other people.
Oh, yes.
Yes. Thank you, God, for the coffee. All right, here we go. Another, I like this one. Let's go with this. Fails.
Fails. Wow.
Mm-hmm. Fails.
How about William Murphy?
Okay.
His love never fails. His love never fails. He was lifted high.
Yes.
On a tree he died. His love never fails.
Yes, his love never fails.
Right.
I like that.
Right.
I like that one. Come on, William. I like that one. His love never fails, no matter what we go through. It's his love for me that does it. Come on, somebody.
That's
his
it.
Love never fails.
That's
we need
it.
The love
his
of love. God, man. Sometimes we do some crazy stuff. We have to admit, sometimes we make bad judgment, bad calls, do things. We get frustrated, angry, right?
Yeah.
At
yeah.
people that we shouldn't be mad at, but something happens, so we're taking out. But his love, never fails, right? His love covers us and keeps us, and I'm just reminded of that love he continues to share for us. Man, his love never fails. I love that. Yeah, his love never fails. Yeah.
Never.
Now mine may be limited.
Yeah.
Okay.
My love may be limited.
It's limited. Don't you count on mine.
Yeah, don't count on my love.
But his love. Yo, come on, somebody. Never fails. All right, we're moving on, shall we? Let's move on. I like it. Let's do another one. Let's do why.
Why? Ooh, it's a tough one.
Mm-hmm.
Can I go with a scripture? Can I do scripture?
Okay, he got a song. Come
yeah,
on.
I ain't got a song.
I'm gonna give you one for
song.
Perfect. Why are we singing? You know that one?
Okay,
how did it go though? Oh, you're the reason why I sing.
Okay, hey. We can do that.
You're the reason why I sing.
Someone asked the question.
Yeah,
that's the
why?
One.
Why do we sing?
Hey. Okay.
When we lift our hands to Jesus.
Yeah.
What do we really mean?
I'm glad you were here. I wasn't gonna think about that.
Come on, Kirk. Okay.
Kirk,
why we sing? Yes, that's it. That's the reason why I sing in my car.
I like it.
And everything like that. Good. Let's keep it moving. Come on. Okay, Brandon.
Okay, Brandon.
Let's go. Next one is Thrive.
Ooh.
Thrive.
Oh, man. This is the $1,000 one on Jeopardy. My goodness. Thrive. Can I phone a friend? Can I call somebody?
Is there anybody in here that can help him with Thrive?
I need something for Thrive.
We gonna buzz it out of time on Thrive. You already called a friend. I helped you with why. I was thinking he was gonna hit.
I knew these were gonna get harder as we went.
that was the concept.
I just knew. I got nothing.
You got nothing.
I'm sorry.
Throw it up. Nobody catch you. All right. It is what it is. All right, here we go. All right, let's go with the next one. Come on, Brandon. I got faith he gonna put it together.
All right,
y'all praying with him? We need to pray in church.
Let's finish strong.
All right, here we go. The next one is goodness.
For your goodness and your mercy towards us.
Yes, sing, Brandon.
For your goodness.
Yes.
And your mercy toward us. We offer praise.
Hey! Yes, God. Your goodness and your mercy towards
us. Lord.
We offer praise. I want to talk to somebody tonight from Psalms 27:13. This is the New King James Version. Mm-hmm. It says it like this. I would have lost heart unless I had believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land of the living. I want to talk to somebody tonight to tell them our God is a good God. Come on.
Our God is a good God.
Yes. His goodness. What does goodness mean? It means the quality of being morally good or virtuous. God's goodness is not predicated upon what we do. It's based upon his quality of being. In other words, God's goodness comes from his ability, character, and essence of being good. So it doesn't matter what you do, God is still good, Brandon.
It doesn't matter
what we don't do, God is still good. It doesn't matter what happens in this world with wars and the stock market, gas prices up, laws being passed to push us back 200 years, God is still good. It doesn't matter if you decided to buy your child McDonald's and your baby mama is mad because she didn't feed her other four children, God is
still good. He's still good.
Why?
He's still good.
Because his goodness has nothing to do with us, but everything to do with who he is.
Yes.
Come on, God is good. David tells us in Psalms 27, it's a very familiar passage of Psalm. He announces to us an exuberant declaration of faith in God. Yeah. Because see, David found himself in Psalms 27 in a situation with his enemies coming against him. He has fear, right? Can easily set in him. But he tells us today, listen, don't lose faith in God. Who am I speaking to today? Don't you lose faith in God. For the Bible says, I would have lost heart unless I believe. Some of us may be facing some major altering life decisions this evening. Heart challenges. You may have cancer or diabetes or may experience a stroke or hypertension, high blood pressure. And you're dealing with these things. And life has taken a toll on you. Life has been coming with all attacks on left, right sides. But God knows what we're facing. And God knows what we're up against. And it looks like you're like a grasshopper going against a giant. But God says tonight, don't lose heart.
My God.
Don't lose faith. Keep believing. Who am I speaking to? Keep believing. Somebody, that's a word for you right there. Keep believing. Yes, I know you want to give up. But God is saying, keep believing. Come on. God is saying, keep believing. God is saying, I know you had dreams of being a lawyer or a doctor or a law officer or going back to school or starting that business or buying that home. It's looking like it's not going to happen. But God says tonight, keep believing. Come on. Why? Because God is faithful. I want to talk to somebody today. The faithfulness of God. He is faithful to perform every promise he's given you. Every promise he's spoken over your life. Everything will come to pass if you keep believing. Next thing we notice in the text is we have to not only keep believing, but I want to tell somebody tonight, stay focused. My God, that's the hard part. Staying focused is the hard part. I'm going to keep believing in you, God. Yes, I'm not going to lose heart in you and faith in you, but I got to stay focused in the process. The text says, now he says, I would have lost heart unless I believed to see the goodness of the Lord. One translation says, I would have fainted. I would have passed out. I would have gone unconscious. Game over, man down, unless. Come on. Yeah. Some of us must ask God to give us an unless. Y'all not hear me? In other words, unless means to expect. To expect on this condition.
Yes.
I would have fainted, but I can't because I know God. I would have had it a different way, but I can't because I believe God. I mean, on anything or any other situation, yeah, that may have happened, but unless, because one thing I know for sure, I know God.
Yes.
Come on, somebody.
Yes.
And listen, God is bigger than the Michael Jordan, but listen, we know anytime you're in crunch time and you playing ball and the clock is getting low and you need a shot, come on.
Yeah.
The person you're going to call on, MJ going to knock it down every single time, right?
That's right.
He's a game changer. And that's the type of God we serve. He is a game changer. God knows how to come in right in the nick of time to do what we need to do. And somebody need to thank God tonight for unless. Come on, I got unless I would
unless,
see. I believe you in spite of, because you've given me an unless type of praise. Come on,
my
somebody.
God,
unless. I know if I didn't see you move in my life before, then I couldn't believe you now. If I didn't see you heal my body before, then I couldn't believe you now, right? If I didn't see you pay my bills or allow some things to happen to provide for me, then I wouldn't believe you now.
Yes.
But I believe you because I got an unless. I've seen it before. And if he did it before, how many know?
He'll do it again.
Please believe
it.
He's going to do it again.
The same God. Yeah.
Same God.
Yeah.
We'll
same
do it again.
One.
Last thing we notice in the text, it says, not only should we not lose faith in God, not only should we stay focused or stay the course, but we should expect something good to happen. My God.
Expect.
Come on, Brandon.
Yeah,
expect something good to happen.
My God.
I would have lost heart unless I believed that I would see the goodness of the Lord in the land. David is expecting God to come through for him in the clutch. We must expect God to be God. We must expect that God is going to do it for us. Not in the sweet by and by. Not when we're on our dying bed and lost mobility and it seems like we have nothing less to give. No! God is so good that he will show us his goodness each and every day while we still live. If it hasn't happened yet, it's going to happen because we have to continue to expect. And if you don't expect something, you won't receive nothing. Come on. You're not expecting things to change or get better. God won't respond to you. He's going to respond based upon your level of expectation.
My God.
I want to encourage somebody tonight to let them know that our God is good. Come on.
Yes,
that's why
is.
The Bible says in Psalms 34 and 8, oh, taste and see, that the Lord is good.
Yes.
Blessed is the man who trusts in him. The Bible further reminds us in Psalms 105, for the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting and his truth endure to all generations. Our God is good. No matter what you're facing, what has had your back against the wall, no matter what elements or enemies you have, God's goodness will prevail. So don't you lose faith. You stay focused and expect something good to happen to you. If you believe he delivered Daniel from his enemies, he can do the same for you. Brandon's gonna pray with us tonight. Come on, somebody. He's gonna pray with us tonight. For those persons who may be watching who says, listen, I had to be reminded that I serve a good God. And being reminded of that, I needed to hear this word tonight. That I need to continue to rejoice on my unless, continue to stay focused. Come on. Don't lose heart no matter what comes my way. And expect something to happen.
Expect something to happen.
Brandon, can you pray for us tonight? Somebody may be watching. They may need this word of encouragement.
Yes, God. Let us pray.
Thank you, God.
God, our Father, we thank you.
Thank you, God.
We thank you, Lord God, first of all, because you are good.
Yes.
Lord God, you are so good.
Thank you, God.
You've been so good to us.
So good.
So many times you've been better to us than we have been to ourselves,
yes,
Lord.
Yes, God.
We thank you that you are good. Even when life is going bad, you are still good.
Yes, God.
Even when finances are going bad, you're still good.
Yes.
Even when health is going bad, you're still good. Even when we are bad,
come
you
on.
Are
still good.
Good.
Yes, God.
So, Lord God, we thank you for your goodness.
Thank you, God.
Lord God, we ask you that for somebody watching, Father, yes. God, you would show them how
yes.
good you can really
yes.
be. We ask you, Father God, because somebody is watching. They need some kind of good to happen in their life.
Yes, God.
They need some kind of good. Everything around them is going bad.
Yes.
Everything around them is failing.
Yes.
But Lord God, we ask that you show them how good you are. We pray, Lord God, for somebody watching right now
yes,
that
God.
They would have a spirit of expectation.
Yes.
Lord God, that they would expect you
yes,
to do
God.
What they need,
in
Father
Jesus
God.
Name.
Lord God, we pray, Lord God, that when they pray,
yes.
they would pray already believing that what they're asking for
yes,
is
God.
Already done. Lord God, put us in a posture of expectation,
yes.
Father God. Put us in a place where we believe it even before we see
yes.
it. That we believe it, Father God, even before you do it,
yes,
Father God.
God.
Lord God, we thank you.
Thank you, God.
For your goodness,
thank
for your
you,
mercy,
God.
Lord God, for your grace upon us, Father
thank
God.
You, God.
Thank you for not giving us what we deserve.
Thank you, God.
But thank you, Lord God, that you give us and bless us
yes.
based upon your goodness, Father God. Somebody watching, Father God, show them how good you really
yes.
are. Make them a testimony, Father
yes.
God, of your goodness, Lord
yes.
God. This is our prayer
yes,
we ask.
God.
In the mighty name of Jesus,
Jesus.
We pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hopefully you've been blessed. Listen, season two, this is a wrap. We're coming back season three hotter and better, liver than ever. Stay tuned for some phenomenal things that's going to happen right here on Elevate. Listen, if you want to sow a seed and be a blessing to this ministry, please do so. Continue to hit us up with Cash App, $FL, or if you're watching, you can see all the ways of giving on the bottom of the screen. Podcast family, I love you. Continue increase each and every week. I appreciate your love and your presence. YouTube, FB, much love to you as well. And until next season, peace and blessings.
Hey, my name is Brandon McCord. Thanks for joining us on Elevate. Don't forget to like, subscribe, follow, and share on all major social media platforms and podcasts. If you would like to join the crew, connect with us on Instagram at anti.up. Until next time, peace.